Hey everyone, and welcome back to another great eShop deals video. Now this week there are over 40 games on my list of eShop deals. However, that does include the games that were already on sale in previous week's video and the video before that. Now, if you want full details on all those games, you can check out those videos after this one. However, I will be giving a shout out really quickly to all the games that are still on sale from those videos. But what's really amazing right now on the eShop is there's a little bit of everything for everyone. If you want to spend a little bit more money, there are some great AAA games that are right now on sale. However, at the same time, if you want some bargain bin games, there are some great indie games at under $5. Now, just before we get started, because we have a ton of games to look at, don't forget to hit that like button. It's the best way to help out the channel. And at the same time, consider subscribing if you aren't already. Now, the first couple of games are going to be just shout outs because they were on last week's list. And that is ATV Drift and Trix. Right now, it's 94% off at only $1.99. This wouldn't be a game I would be recommending at full price, but for only $2, it's a ton of arcade fun. Then we have the amazing Dead Cells that is still 50% off at $12.49, an amazingly difficult yet satisfying roguelite game. Now, I am going to mention really quickly, just because I couldn't go buy it, Just Dance 2021 is already 40% off. I'm not a huge fan of this series, but I did have to mention it for anyone out there that does like the Just Dance games. At $29.99, this is about the lowest they get to, so it is now a decent time to pick it up if you're into this series or if you have kids that really like the Just Dance series. Now, the first new game I want to take a look at for this week is Blue Fire. Right now, the sale isn't huge at only 10% off, dropping it to $17.99. However, this game just came out this week. And already, I did a Let's Play on it, and it is shaping up to be a pretty amazing game. I've done some extra playtime off-screen for it, and trust me, the game is turning out to be really solid. It's basically a blend between a 3D Zelda and Dark Souls. If you ever wished that 3D Zelda was like 5 times harder than it already is, well, Blue Fire might be a game that will interest you. And it does aim a little bit more on the Metroidvania, like a 3D Metroidvania type style of gameplay. But trust me, so far, if you're not sure about the game, check out my Let's Play video. My review will be coming out shortly as well, but so far it's turning out to be a really solid game. Next, a quick shout out, Goblin Sword is still on sale for 3 more days, a great 2D platformer at only $1.99 because it is currently 60% off. Now, the next game had been off the deals list for a few weeks, but it's back and the deal is even better than before, and that is Immortals Fenyx Rising that is now 40% off at $35.99. Now, what's great about this game is it's a blend basically of Breath of the Wild, but with combat that's a lot more like the old school God of Wars, like God of War 3 and earlier. And honestly, although this game, I would never say is as good as Breath of the Wild, it really has its own place and its own style. And it has a really comedic storyline, which is great. And as a final point, there's a free downloadable demo, and there's even now the first part of the DLC available. By the way, there is a pack on sale, including the DLC, but if you're not 100% sure that you're going to love this game, you can buy the base version and the DLC later, because the pack is actually not giving you any discount on the DLC. It's the same price as if you bought the game on sale here and then bought the DLC separately later. So don't feel bad, you can try out the base game and pick up the DLC later if you loved it. Now, the next game is an arcade-style racer that I just tried this week, and that is Gear Club Unlimited. When it dropped to 80% off at only $2.98, for $3, I said, why not give it a try? And you know what? It's a pretty solid arcade racer for that price. It's nowhere as polished as, let's say, a Need for Speed Hot Pursuit, but at $3, it's really hard to complain, and you're going to get some really solid and fun gameplay out of it if you're into the arcade-style racers. Now, the next game series that are currently all on sale are the LEGO games. Now, these are just some great easygoing games to pick up when you just want to lay back and just chill out and have a little bit of fun. These are great games to play with as well with younger kids. And right now, all of the LEGO games are on sale. And as every time they fall on sale, what I say is basically pick up the ones that are featuring the characters that you're into. If you're a superhero fan, pick up the Marvel and the DC ones. If you're a Harry Potter fan, you pick up the Harry Potter one. Now, we're not going to go into details into each of the different series, but I am going to do a quick shout out as we pass by them. And right now, the cheapest one on sale is the LEGO Marvel Super Heroes 2 that is 70% off at only $8.99. So if you're not sure about any of these games and you just want to try one out, I would say pick this one up first. It's probably the cheapest one on the list. Now, the next game on the list is a survival game, and that is Green Hell. That is 50% off for only $12.49. Now, I have to actually thank a viewer for this one because I had missed this game in the past. I really dismissed it because I didn't think it would be solid. But honestly, this is a really fun survival game. It's played from a first-person perspective, but if you're into that whole dropped onto a desert island, build your shelter, and just fight to survive, Green Hell is an amazing open world experience. And honestly, I'm actually disappointed that I waited so long to play this game. So honestly, if there's a game that if you're into the survival type that you should try out, Green Hell is definitely the game for this. Now, the next game that is back on sale on the list is the Assassin's Creed Rebel Collection. That is 50% off, dropping it to $19.99. Every time this pack is on sale, I recommend it because you get two really solid Assassin's Creed games for only 20 bucks. That is an amazing value and gives you a ton of hours of gameplay. Now, if you've never tried the Assassin's Creed series, it's basically a 3D action gameplay. And honestly, my personal favorite is Black Flag, which is in this pack. So right now, honestly, is a great time to pick this one up. Now, just a quick shout out, as I said, the LEGO Harry Potter collection is on sale. You get to play through basically the storyline of every one of the Harry Potter movies, and it's 70% off, dropping the game to only $14.99. Now, the next game we're going to take a look at is my top choice for this week. If you don't know what to buy and you want to drop like a $15 on a game, that is Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle. It's basically the Mario and Rabbids characters that are thrown into an XCOM style strategy gameplay. Now, honestly, I know it sounds crazy at first, but this really works and it's a very high quality and very well polished game. And what's even better is right now it's 75% off with the base pack only $14.99. But if you've already heard of this game or you're pretty sure you're gonna like it, what's even better right now is for only $19.99, there's a bundle including all the DLC that is also on sale for the eShop. And this one, the DLC is on sale in the pack as well. So it is worth picking up the bundle if you're looking at buying this game and you want the whole thing at once. Now, another quick shout out, the LEGO Jurassic World game is here. As I said, another one of the LEGO games on sale, 70% off for only $11.99. So if you love the Jurassic World franchise, pick this one up. Now, another great series of games that are on sale are the Mega Man games this week. Basically, Capcom has dropped a sale on all the Mega Man games, with the cheapest ones being at $9.99 and the most expensive ones being at around $20. And basically, each one of these collections are great to pick up. If this is your first time playing Mega Man, it's basically a 2D platforming shooter. It's one of the classic series from the NES days. And basically, if you're unsure and you want to try one out for first, the best collection to start with is the one that I have on screen right now, the Mega Man X Legacy Collection, the first part. Now, if you end up really liking this, after that, you can jump right into the other Mega Man games. But once again, for this series, we're not going to go into details for each one of the different parts, but I will give a shout out to each one so that you see where they are and how much they are as we go through the video. Now, the next game that is back on sale is South Park: The Stick of Truth. Now, this is basically a South Park-based RPG. And what I love about this game is it's honestly like you're playing through a huge episode of South Park. All the humor is there, just like in a regular episode, and the gameplay is actually really solid for a standard RPG as well. And right now, at 60% off for $11.99, it's actually a pretty fantastic pickup. It does fall on sale often like this, but like I said, I've never seen it lower. Now, once again, a quick shout out. On screen, we have two more of the Mega Man packs that are on sale. Basically, this is the most expensive one, the Mega Man Zero ZX Legacy Collection, which is only 34% off, dropping it to $19.79. I would say this is the pack that would be most directed to someone who already knows they're a Mega Man fan, because this is basically from the Game Boy and DS era, and basically it's sort of a Mega Man slash almost little bit of a Metroidvania elements thrown in. And I would say, personally, I find they're some of the toughest because they're non-linear. However, at the same time, they are great games. Check them out if you're already into Mega Man and you haven't had a chance to play through this series. And secondly, we had the Mega Man X Legacy Collection 2 also on sale. Like I said, I would start with Pack 1. If you really love the games, then jump to the Legacy Collection 2, because basically, I would say some of these games are hit or miss. Not all of them are the best Mega Mans out there. Some of them are just so-so, but nonetheless, at $10, you're still getting a great pack with four great Mega Man X games. Now, while we're on the topic of shoutouts, another LEGO game here on sale, the LEGO DC Supervillains, which is actually the latest one to come out, and I would say the most polished of all the games. And right below it, we also have the Mega Man Legacy Collection that is 33% off at $9.99, which are the first six original games from the NES era. Now, next, we are going to be looking at my top pick if you don't know what to pick up on the budget side this week, and that is Crypt of the NecroDancer, that is currently 80% off, dropping it to only $3.99. Now, this is basically a procedurally generated roguelite adventure game, but based on rhythm. And honestly, this is such a fantastic game that after Nintendo saw this game, they basically hired a company to make a Zelda version of it. This is the game that basically came before that. Crypt of the NecroDancer is an amazing roguelite experience. And like I said, if there's one game on the budget side, if you don't know what to pick up for this week, I would choose this game. Another quick shout out, the LEGO The Incredibles is also on sale, 70% off, dropping it to $17.99. If you are really into the Incredibles series, this could be a very good pickup. Now the next game is the second South Park RPG game, and that is South Park The Fractured Butthole. And basically, this is once again a RPG, but this time it is a grid-based strategy RPG. So they flipped up the gameplay a little bit, but it is still a very solid game. My personal favorite is the first one, but the second one is just almost just as amazing. And at 75% off for only $14.99, this is once again generally the lowest it goes. And it's a great time to pick it up. And what I loved most about this game, once again, is the humor. It's once again like you're playing through an episode of South Park. Now, the next game, I'm actually going to take a few seconds, although it's in the Mega Man series, and that is Mega Man 11, which is the next generation of the original series. Now, this one was actually released on next-gen consoles, and it's currently 50% off at only $14.99. And I find that often this game is on sale, and I don't take the time to mention it just because I think everyone already knows about it. But honestly, this is a really solid platforming shooter. Even if you're not a Mega Man fan, this is a really solid purchase. And plus, there's a downloadable demo that you can try for free. And honestly, this relaunched the classic Mega Man series and brought it really up to form to the original, which is a great thing to see, and I hope Capcom keeps down the same alley. So honestly, if you want to pick it up, this is a great purchase. Now, two more shoutouts on the screen. Monster Boy is still on sale for 50% off at $19.99, which is an amazing 2D platformer. Check out my previous videos. This is one of my all-time favorite 2D platformers on the Switch currently. Monster Boy is a really solid game, but it is more on the expensive side of the indie type games at $19.99. Now, the second thing we have on screen is the Mega Man Legacy Collection 2, which is the original Mega Man series, but the continuation, basically Mega Man 7 through 10. And these are two original games that were actually produced years after the original series ended, but in the original format, which is Mega Man 9 and Mega Man 10, which are actually really, really great games on it. But I would say that this is once again for someone who is already a fan of Mega Man, because they are some of the more challenging of the games. Now, another quick shout out, Blossom Tales is still on sale for 50% off at $7.49. Now, this is basically as close as you can get to a classic top-down Zelda game without it actually being called Zelda. And it is a great experience, and at 50% off is an awesome pickup. Once again, another shout out, Robonauts is also still on sale for $1.99, which is a great blend between a platformer and a twin stick shooter. Check it out. Another game that's still on sale from the previous week is Valferrus, which is an amazing 2D platform shooter. It's a great pickup at $11.24. Now, the next game is a new entry on the series, and that is Slime San. It is right now 75% off for only $2.99. Now, this is an amazing platformer. It is sort of in the Super Meat Boy type style of gameplay, but it is actually one of the really, really solid entries in that type. Plus, it once again has a downloadable demo that you can try out. This is a really great game, and at only $3, if you're into really difficult platformers, it is really, really worth your time. Now, the next section of the video, I'm just warning you, is going to have 5 or 6 shoutouts back to back from last week's video. The first one being Miles and Kilo, which at $1.99 is a really awesome Mario-styled 2D platformer. So it's a more of a laid-back, not a hardcore difficult platformer, but still a very solid experience, especially at $1.99. We also have the pack of Bleed and Bleed 2 that is still on sale at $4.19, which is once again a platform shooter type game. Amazing experience for only $4. Also from last week's video, Odalus is still on sale at $3.59, 70% off, a Castlevania style 2D platformer. The Horror Bundle is also still on sale at $4.56. I always recommend this bundle primarily because Slain is in it, and Slain is a really awesome but slightly gory action platformer. Now, the last two shoutouts before we get to a new game for this week, we have Kyo Blaster that is still at $1.99, which is, you know, a reference style would be basically the Parodia series or the Flying Levels of Cuphead, but it's a game that is totally like that, although not as difficult. And lastly, Onikin, which is just a really solid 2D action platformer in the NES style at $2.99. So now we get to a new game for this week, which is Hebroxia, which is a really solid space shooter. What actually turned me on to this game is the second one just came out this week, and the first one automatically dropped to 60% off for $3.19. So before trying the second one, I said, let's give the first one a whirl. And it is a really solid side-scrolling space shooter. And what I love about this is that basically it has some branching paths, giving you some different ways to approach each level. And overall, the gameplay is just very, very solid. And especially at $3.19, this is one of the better space shooters I've tried. While we're on the topic of space shooters, I have another one for you this week. That is Ghostblade HD, which is 60% off at $5.99. Now, at full price, I would have said that this game wasn't worth it. But at 60% off, all of a sudden, this game becomes very relevant. Why? Because it's another great space shooter with some really solid graphics. The only thing is the gameplay was a little bit generic. I didn't find that there was very many original elements added to it, although the visual style was very appealing. And on sale at 60% off, all of a sudden, this game really becomes worth it if you're a fan of space shooters, because overall, it still is a really solid entry. Now, yet another shout out from last week is Tanuki Justice. That is still 25% off for only $11.24, and is a very difficult side-scrolling action game. It is done in an old school style, but trust me, this is one fun game. However, you have to appreciate a challenge, because this is not an easy game in any way. Now, once again, a mention from last week's video, Xenoraptor is still on sale, which is a twin stick shooter mixed between 2 and 3D. However, this week there is one that I would suggest before this one, and it is a new entry, and it's just coming up. And while we're on the topic of that twin stick shooter, well, here it is, and that is Inferno 2. Now at $1.99, this is an amazing twin stick shooter, not only because of the visuals, but because of the gameplay. The controls are extremely solid. There's some really nice progressive RPG mechanics to it as well, which really keeps you coming back and back for more gameplay. So honestly, if you're into twin stick shooters, this is one of my overall favorites on the Switch at only $1.99. It is definitely worth the pickup. And now right next to it, we have our before last game for this week's list, and that is the Bug Butcher, which is just an amazing platforming shooter. And it's just a ton of fun if you just like shooting stuff right, left, and center. Because basically all it is it's more of a vertical styled gameplay. Everything will be coming from this top of the screen, and you've just got to keep moving right to left and shooting everything that comes at you. And it's just a ton of fun, and especially at 60% off for $3.19, and it's an amazing experience for under $5. And now to end this week's list, we have a last shout out for last week's list, which is the Grip Bundle that is 80% off for $8.59, an awesome arcade racer that lets you drive basically up the walls, even on the ceiling. Check out last week's video if you want a few more details, but honestly at $8.59, it's a really decent pickup. So now that's pretty much it for this week's list. I'm gonna tell you, this list was getting so massive, I really didn't think we would be able to get to all the games, but I'm pretty glad that I think we managed to condense this in a pretty absorbable format. As usual, I really want to hear from all of you, so let me know what you picked up. Let me know if there's any games I missed for this week that are on sale that I should really try out for future videos. Now, as I said at the beginning of the video, please don't forget to hit that like button. It's the best way to help out the channel. Also, subscribe if you aren't already, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so you know when all my videos come out. And as usual, I hope I'll see you in my next video.